that. It's become Cristiano Ronaldo's trademark, to the extent Neymar even did it with Brazil. This celebration went down in football history, but it's not the only one. Number one, Calma Calma. Cristiano Ronaldo's Calma Calma is the Portuguese player's first trademark celebration. Before the CR7 simply told the crowd to calm down after his goal. Calma Calma, I'll look after everything. I'm CR7. So, naturally, in an away game, especially against Barca, it had a big impact. But CR7 found something even better. Number two, the Sue. The celebration that you can see here is Cristiano Ronaldo's Sue. But not just any, because this is the very first one. It was when Real Madrid played against Chelsea in the United States. And I don't know how I came up with it. I like it, and I started to do it regularly. I saw that people liked it and asked me to do it. So, I kept doing it. He kept doing it, and it's still his go-to celebration to this day. Number three, Messi's jersey. Clásico 2017, Real Madrid, FC Barcelona. Leo Messi scores a match-winning goal for Barca. The final score is 3-2, and while his shot is unforgettable, what everyone remembers best is this crazy celebration. He showed the Merengue fans his jersey, his name, and his number, in case they didn't know who he was. For all the purists out there, we're not finished. Yes, it was Ronaldinho with Paris Saint-Germain in 2003 Classique against Marseille who popularized this celebration. Oh, Ronnie! For Messi, we could have also talked about his famous tribute to Maradona that was just as amazing as he was iconic. Number 4. Diego's Rage. The perfect transition. Diego Maradona did one of the craziest celebrations in history. In 1994, during the World Cup hosted by the United States, Diego was in hostile territory because the land of Uncle Sam didn't particularly like him, and he was fighting his cocaine addiction, for which he'd been suspended for 15 months in 1991. In the first game of the group stages, Argentina took on Greece and Diego scored another crazy goal before celebrating in an appropriately crazy way. He stared at the camera and screamed with almost terrifying rage. I shouted at the camera, but not because I was high, as some idiots claimed. I did it because I wanted everyone to understand that I was back. A very short comeback, because this goal was El Pibe de Oro's last for the Argentine team. Since after this match, he played in the game against Nigeria before getting kicked out of the competition after testing positive for ephedrine. Number 5. Muscleor by Balotelli. It's the ultimate celebration from Mario Balotelli as it sums him up perfectly. Talent on one side, his personality on the other. During the Euro 2012 semi-final against Germany, Super Mario scored an amazing shot in the top corner of Manuel Neuer's goal, the best goalkeeper in the world, before taking off his jersey, flexing his muscles, and pulling a grimace. That says it all, talent and madness. Aside from this, from Balo, we could have also talked about his celebration in the Manchester Derby, the "Why Always Me" that he wrote under his t-shirt. Number 6. One too many topless celebrations. Another perfect transition here, because the reason Balotelli got a yellow card in 2012 was because of Diego Forlan, who didn't leave his mark on Manchester United's history, but the history of the rules in the game. After one goal, he celebrated passionately and took off his shirt. Except he wasn't able to put it back on before play resumed, and he played for a short time holding his jersey. To fight against this more and more common phenomenon, FIFA and IFAB, the organization in charge of the rules, decided to include being topless as a foul worthy of a yellow card. So, since 2004, removing your jersey to celebrate a goal is banned and punishable with a yellow card. Whether it's to show your abs or even a tribute to a loved one or a cause, it's a yellow card. And that's because of Diego Forlan. Number 7. The Baby Toe. Bebeto will remember July 1994 forever. While playing in the World Cup with Brazil, his son was born on July 7th. 2 days later, he scored against the Netherlands in a crazy match. And to celebrate his goal and becoming a father, he mimicked rocking his son as a celebration. Even better, Mazinho and Romario joined him and synchronized with him. The cherry on the cake? Brazil won this 1994 World Cup. Like I said, July 94 was a very good month for Bebeto. Number 8. A popped collar like Eric. On December 21st, 1996, Eric Cantona entered the history books yet again. For his pure genius, because he scored an exceptional goal. There are no other words. But also for his legendary and unforgettable celebration. While his lob hadn't even gone into the goal, he stopped, and once the goal was scored, he turned around with disrespectful slowness, his collar popped like usual, and looked at the stands. If we had to score this celebration, you can't help but give him full marks. Exceptional, from the highest level. Number 9. Henry's goalpost. In 2013, Thierry Henry went down in the history of American football. Well, soccer anyway. After an umpteenth MLS goal with the New York Red Bulls against Toronto, he decided to celebrate in the simplest of fashions. He leaned against the goalpost. Simple, but effective. And don't forget, this celebration was one of the very first football memes on the internet. We could have also talked about his crazy slide during his legendary goal in the derby between Arsenal and Tottenham in 2002. This legendary celebration was then commemorated by a 440-pound bronze statue which stands proudly outside the Emirates Stadium. Pure class. Number 10. Roger Milla. Cameroon versus Colombia in the 1990 World Cup, Roger Milla scored for the indomitable Lions and ran up to the corner flag. The striker started dancing around the Makossa, and his dance moves were seen all over the world. Personally, I remember the celebration more than the goal. Proof that it's a historic celebration. Number 11. Andres Homage. The 2010 World Cup Final. Andres Iniesta gave Spain their very first World Cup title. An exceptional moment that he decided to dedicate to Dani Jarque, the Espanyol Barcelona captain who passed away 11 months earlier. Iniesta ran toward the corner, took off his jersey to reveal a t-shirt which had Dani Jarque, always with us, written on it. An amazing gesture that propelled Iniesta into the heart of Espanyol Barcelona fans. Huge rivals of Barca. He was even applauded during Espanyol Barca. Among the unforgettable celebrations, there are also players' specials. We talked about Messi and Ronaldo, but there's also Antoine Griezmann, Paulo Dybala, Edinson Cavani, Luca Toni, Didier Drogba, and so on. Which was your favorite celebration? Let us know in the comments.